two new drugs to fight COVID-19 developed. While the world has several vaccines against COVID-19, we have a major shortage of effective drugs that could save patients with severe symptoms. Recently, scientists at QIMR Berghofer Medical Research Institute announced the current status of their COVID-19 treatments. They revealed that two drugs capable of preventing SARS-CoV-2 infection have reached preclinical trials. These are the first drugs we are aware of that can operate on dual fronts. We hope, if the clinical trials are successful, that the first drug could be given as a therapy alongside vaccination, said Professor Sudha Rao, study senior author. Unlike most drugs that address viral infections, the two experimental anti-COVID medications are meant to target human cells. The approach is to manipulate how human cells will respond to the coronavirus. Using peptides, scientists designed one drug for pre-exposure and the other for preventing the spread of the virus within infected cells. These peptide-based drugs were based on a previously unknown mode of entry used by the coronavirus. Some people have a chemical tag that acts as a padlock on the ACE2 receptor, the one needed by the virus to infect. Those with this chemical tag are less likely to get COVID, but those without may be more susceptible. The first peptide drug works by cloaking the ACE2 receptor on human cells to reduce the risk of infection. Upon contact, the coronavirus would attach to the cloaking peptides instead of the receptor, preventing infection. But the virus is tenacious and may find a way to hijack cells. The second peptide drug serves as a fail-safe of the first drug, where it blocks the virus's hijacking and replication processes. Plus, it can help the immune system recognize the pathogen. Together, the drugs stop the tag from being removed and protect untagged receptors from getting infected. One of the possible advantages of these drugs is efficacy against SARS-CoV-2 variants, both existing and upcoming. Since the variants apply the same way of infecting human cells, the drugs are expected to work and reduce the transmission potential of these variants. However, one of the concerns is side effects, which are not yet completely known. Right now, scientists are testing the effects of the drugs in hamsters at a clinical research facility. Early data suggests that the drugs are not toxic and have limited side effects. They also found that the drugs are stable at room temperature.